some of them are fictitious. So what I did is a lot of the things that, you know, sometimes you live your day and somebody tells you a comment or a story and just stick in your head, and somehow later on will come out in one way or the other. So these were stories that were in my head. And then one day in a drive from Austin to Los Angeles, kind of like the whole story came together, and that's how Bella came to life. I met him, but no, we never got the opportunity to work. Actually, when I was in film school, I was completely out of it. I was, you know, I kind of only saw one step at a time, and I was very focused, so I kind of was just working on my short films to the point of even forgetting that I needed to pay rent, using my rent money to pay for the film, and to the point that I was like, you know what, I don't really need to pay rent, so why don't I just leave without work? And I found a little couch on the 7th floor at the University of Texas. So we have, the University of Texas had one of the greatest gyms in the nation for a university. So, you know, I had a spa and the whole thing. So, you know, I was just working really hard until I graduated. And I didn't really get the opportunity to work with other filmmakers from Austin. Well, in my mind, you know, this is a love story. And they were, you know, to me, the true love is when romance is put aside. Romance is beautiful. So they started their relationship deeper than romance. So in my mind, Bella needed a mother, and she was ready. You know, through the whole film, we learned that she was not ready. And in the script, in one of the versions there, we learned that what happened to Nina in those 4 years, and also we learned that it was her birthday. But, you know, when you're telling a story, sometimes the moments are more important than the details. So that's when I decided to, you know, to cut some of the things out and just focus on the moments that really changed their lives forever. So in my head, they get married. But the biggest challenge that we had in this film, the biggest that I have to put on number one, was time. You know, time is worth a lot of money in film. So, you know, when you hear a $100 million film, you're hearing 4 or 5 months of shooting. So that's what you hear. And in our film, you know, we had to shoot the whole film in 23 days. So that was very, very difficult. You know, I was used to, from film school, shooting one page a day and really, you know, playing with my camera angles. All my, I was being recognized by my cinematography. And in this film, it was very, very difficult to really, you know, take the time and work with the actors and really. So a lot of the times, like, I have to give a lot of credit to Eduardo, because, you know, acting is harder when you're not talking, you know. It's like in real life, you know, it's harder to listen. You know, it's really like to speak, and when the other person is speaking, you already start thinking about the bills, what you're doing the next day, and you're acting like you're listening to the other person. Well, in acting is the same thing. You know, when Eduardo's character, I wanted him to speak without words, you know, because I didn't want him to never come as judgmental what Nina was going through. So it was very hard, because I will tell Eduardo, you know, everything I needed, but you have one take. So that was one of the situations that it was a huge challenge. You know, sometimes I had to shoot 9, 10 pages in one day, when you normally should shoot 2 to 3 pages. So time was a big, big challenge. Shooting in New York locations, we had, you know, over 25 locations, so changing locations in that period of time. It was very, very, very difficult. But, you know, we were reacting every day, and it was just miracle after miracle happened in the film, and we were able to finish the film. That was, to me, at the end, a miracle, you know, because many, many films with way bigger budgets don't finish. It's very, very hard. You know, some kind of magic needs to happen to wrap everything. So that was one of the situations. It's not hard. You know, I went through 3 editors in here. And actually, I was one of them. And then I got fined by the unions. And then I finally found my 3rd editor. And when an editor you don't trust starts cutting your movie out, it really hurts a lot. But the 3rd editor, he was like a meat cutter. You know, the movie used to be like 2.5 hours. And he came in one day and he actually told me that I cannot be in the editing room, but I trusted him very much. So when I came, I didn't question him. I said, hey, this is great. I missed these 20 other scenes, but, you know, it's better that, you know, editors know what to tell, how to tell a story. So I had to trust him. And I was looking for that particular person. And after a lot of work, finally happened. By the way, if you guys have any questions for the actors, I'll be happy to answer.
We're going to turn it over to Ramon. You all remember Ramon because of Victoria. And we're going to... Veronica. Obviously, I don't remember. Veronica. Very good. Well, that was the lead-in. We're going to have you move over to the other side. We're going to turn it over to you. And if you remember, for the humor in the show came from Ramon, who was Eduardo, who brought the whole family together. And if you have any questions directed to him, we'd like to have them. And we're going to ask Ali and Alejandro to move on to the next theater where we have another group of people waiting to hear from them.
Thank you. One thing, you know, that line was when he said, I think I found the woman of my life. And Nina says, how long have you been dating? He says, a week. Well, that's real life. That's, I call my mom and I say, I think I found my wife. And she's like, oh, well, how long have you been dating? And it was a week. So I had to put the line in the film, but it seems to work. So now we're married. So.
You want to take the microphone? Take the microphone. Very good.
Thank you for abandoning me. Thank you. Yeah, exactly. There's another story that was actually true, too, that he ended up telling me was the scar on my arm. He actually has that same scar on his arm, and that actually happened to him. So does anybody have any questions? Any questions at all? He knew exactly what he wanted. He was very clear. His direction, every time we stepped in, we rehearsed things a lot. I mean, it wasn't a lot of time, but he did take the time to rehearse, which is very generous. You don't always get time to rehearse sometimes. And when it was time to shoot, he knew exactly what he wanted. That dinner scene was very complex because there was a lot of things going on, people eating and, you know, six characters on a table, and you had to cover everybody. So, you know, with the amount of time that he had, he pulled many miracles off. But I think it was due to the rehearsal and that he was very specific. So he already had a vision in his mind, which made it very easy for him to kind of just, all we had to do now was execute. So that was my feat. And you know what? I'm gonna expose something. And I know Eduardo's going to be very upset, but I'm not going to let him take credit for it. Those are my feet in the beginning of the film, too. I had to do it. I'm sorry. I should get a credit up there. Those are my feet. No, just kidding. But, yeah, he found out that I could dance, and he was like, oh, when you throw on the record, could you do some dance moves? And I'm like, oh, sure, I'm going to have fun. You know, I'm a salsa dancer. I love to dance. And then when we finished shooting all of my scenes, he called me back and said, oh, we have one more day of work. I'm like, what do you mean? We shot all my scenes. I saw we shot everything. He goes, I just need you for one more thing. I'm like, oh, okay. I get on set and he's, can you throw on these red shoes on? And so then that's when I figured it out. I said, oh, I'm going to make somebody else look good. No problem. No, it's all for the film. So, yeah. He didn't necessarily talk about it. He did tell me, I mean, I remember the notes he told me in the beginning. He was like, I don't mean to put pressure on you, but this character is almost like me when I was young. And I'm like, oh, great. I have the director telling me that I have to, you know, live up to this role because it's him. It was written with a lot of, I could tell just by the energy and the writing. I was like, okay, this is the kind of character. I mean, I am a younger brother in my family. I was raised by three older sisters and my mom. So maybe that's where it came from, in a small little apartment. So, I mean, you know, you got to have energy and you got to be happy when you're living in a small space with four women. I love women. I mean, nothing against that, but it's the truth. It's just a tiny space. Is, you know, you got to love. You can get mad and you can just turn and then everyone's still there. It's like, all right, we got to face this because can't run into a room or anything. So, yeah, that's how that. Oh, thank you. Well, I appreciate that. Thank you very, 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 very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Beautiful. We're going to finish with one little story that some of you may know and some of you may not. Tammy, who's in the movie, who has to make some tough decisions, was working on another film at the time with Robert De Niro, and it was called The Good Shepherd. Tammy, in the movie, played the part of Matt Damon's wife. In the middle of making The Good Shepherd, which is a much bigger budget movie, they had an opening for 2 weeks that got extended to 3 weeks, and everyone was supposed to take a vacation, come back refreshed, and be ready to finish The Good Shepherd. Tammy went back to Robert De Niro and said, I'm going to do another movie during my vacation called Bella. And Robert De Niro said, it's time for you to make a decision. If you decide to do Bella, you're out of The Good Shepherd. She hesitated for a moment, just a moment. She said, I'm sorry, Mr. De Niro. I'm out of The Good Shepherd. He was so moved. He was so moved by that response. He knew it was genuine. He changed his mind on the spot. She made the movie. She wasn't going to be chosen. She was really the third choice. But she walked back into Alejandro and she said, you have to know I am your Nina. That did it. That convinced it. And that is just the spirit of this whole movie that's going on and on. Ramon is terrific. Added a lot of humor. We're now going to go out and have some dessert and coffee. We hope you stay with us and have a chance to meet all the actors personally. And they're going to be willing to sign posters and so forth that are going to be given to you as you leave the room. Thank you very, very much.